He stays at the Breakers Hotel, the premier hotel. He's a Miami Beach kind of guy. He went there all when he's growing up at the Fountain Blue Hotel. That was his hotel. He stays at the Breakers. It's raining, so he gets a limo. Has a limo driving around the town, and he says, "What's for sale?" And the driver says, "Well, Mar-a-Lago is for sale." Now, if Donald Trump was part of the Eastern establishment, he would know what Mar-a-Lago was. Mar-a-Lago was built in the 20s by Marjorie Meriwether Post, this incredible mansion, 85,000 square feet on 17 acres. For the year she was building it, she cornered the market on gold guild. You couldn't get gold guild for anything else in America. That's how much gold there is in this building. Trump goes in and sees it, and he thinks it's just fantastic. He loves it, and he decides he has to have it. He's in his mid-30s. I mean, he doesn't have the money for a place like this, but he wants it. The Mrs. Post, in her last years, had given the estate to the American government for a winter White House. That's the way she wanted it would last forever. The government took it, but the presidents didn't want to come down here. Can you imagine Jimmy Carter at Mar-a-Lago? He wasn't going to use it. So the government gave it back to the Post Foundation. They put it on sale for $20 million. It was on sale for several years. There were several bids around the $14 or $15 million, and Trump gets it. He gets $5 million for the estate, and he pays $3 million for the furnishings that are worth a lot more than that, and $2 million for this strip of land, this narrow strip of land. And Donald Trump, about 15 years later, said, "Sometimes you do dirty to get a deal, and I did dirty to get that deal."